What's My Line? Brought to you by Geritol, the high-potency vitamin iron-rich tonic in liquid or tablets to help you feel stronger. And now, let's all play What's My Line? And now, live from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now, a very delightful gentleman indeed, who, with his three glorious confreres, has just completed the 300th performance of the comedy hit Beyond the Fringe, Mr. Peter Cook.
It's my pleasure to introduce the celebrated crime reporter, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Thank you. And it's my pleasure to introduce the president of Random House, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
Here's our distinguished panel moderator, a man with a superb physique. In fact, he has one of the largest vocabularies extant, Mr. John Charles Daly.
Well, Peter Cook, it's nice to see you on the panel. Matter of fact, I think we're going to give you a good half hour. We have some fun here for you. Arlene and I are going to be a little proud and peacock tonight. We're going to be at Miss Universe next Saturday. And just think of the rest of you folks. So we'll try to be...
Miss Universe.
You're going to be Mrs. Universe or Miss Universe. I don't know which, on Saturday. But we do have some fun, I think, tonight in hand for you. And we'll also have a famous mystery guest before our panel a little bit later in the program. We'll meet our first challenger after this one. And now to meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Carolyn Doggerty, is that right? Is it Miss or Mrs.?
Miss.
Miss Doggerty. And where are you from, ma'am?
Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Philadelphia? City of brotherly love. It's nice to have you with us. Miss Doggerty, may I present our panel? Now, will you join me over here? Do you know how we keep score on What's My Line?
Yes, I do.
All right, fine. Then we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right, panel, we can tell you that Miss Doggerty is salaried and deals in a service, and we'll begin the general questioning with Bennett Cerf.
Miss Doggerty, am I correct in surmising that there's a bit of Irish in you, somewhere or other?
Yes.
It's inconceivable to me that a girl as lovely as you wouldn't have something to do with the field of entertainment. Have you?
No.
No?
That's one down, nine to go, Miss Fred.
Do you work for a profit-making organization?
Yes, I do.
Do you work indoors?
Sometimes.
You move around in your work?
Yes.
You personally move around?
Yes.
Is there anything athletic at all in what you do?
No.
Nope. Two down and eight to go, Mr. Cook.
Miss Dorothy, if I was to come to you for your service, would I be more likely to catch you inside or outside? Or would I follow you around as you move from... one part to the other.
Well, now, that's two questions, Peter.
I realize there's no answer to it. I'm just biding my time. I was thinking of going to the diplomatic service before I did this. Would I find you inside?
Yes.
When you had rendered this service, would I... have benefited in an intellectual capacity? Would I have learned something about something from you?
Well, I would say here this would much depend on your relationship to Miss Dougherty at the time that the service was conveyed. Under one circumstance, we would agree that you might learn something, right?
Yeah.
Under another, we might agree that you still had learned something, but might not necessarily seek the information.
I see. I might be about as puzzled as I am now, in fact. in your outside capacity, do you work at all with animals?
No.
No. 3 down and 7 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Could I use your services, too?
Yes.
Do you work with your hands?
You mean specifically to the exclusion of,
Oh, I don't want to exclude anything.
But to the exclusion of the normal experience of, do you work, I mean, we wouldn't say you worked with your hands as a specific fact, but you do use your hands in your work. Now, how
yes,
do you mean?
I type.
Yeah. Well, now, do you mean, does Miss Dougherty ever use her hands, or does she principally use her hands?
Ever.
Ever. Well, I guess you're in pretty safe ground now.
Do you, when you move from indoors to outdoors, move for a reason rather than just the fact that you like it outdoors more than indoors?
Yes.
Is it because there are people out there who want your service?
No.
Well, here again, with your permission, Miss Dougherty, I would say that people are involved, that if Miss Dougherty went outside, it would probably have something to do with people. It would be something with, I mean, if you would take her from one place to another. That's fair, isn't it?
Yes.
Do people pay you directly rather than charging it?
No.
They charge.
4 down. No, they don't. And actually, remember, Miss Dougherty works for a profit-making organization. This has been, I think, developed and deals in a service. Mr. Cerf?
Miss Dougherty, yes. Do you require any special training for the service that you perform?
Yes.
Is it a certain kind of schooling that you need?
You mean leading to a degree or having the
Not
character?
Not necessarily having a degree, but some kind of training in some kind of course that enables you to do the work that you are now doing.
Yes.
Do you wear any kind of special uniform for the work that you do?
No.
5 down and 5 to go, Miss Francis.
I have a feeling we're getting no place.
You are.
Yes. We're getting no place.
Do you ever take anybody outside that has been inside with you?
No.
You don't
no,
take
I
them out?
Sometimes.
It's possible that in the conveyance of the service, Miss Dougherty might have occasion to take somebody outside who was inside.
Yes.
Would you ever work with people that were not quite well?
None of us are, really.
Well, not specifically, and the fact of their health or lack
is
of it would
no
not be germane. No, that's 6 down and 4 to go. I'm going to give you one more minute because you're wandering afield.
Do you think us asking you the whole time whether you go in or out is any help to us at all?
No, that's absolutely right. No, that's 7 down and 3 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Do you work in or near a building that has any significance other than an office building? In other words, if we knew what kind of a building you worked in or near, would we have a clue to your profession?
Not necessarily.
Not necessarily.
No. 8 down and 2 to go, Mr. Cerf.
Miss Dougherty, does your service... We never did establish the fact that whether or not you worked for a profit-making organization.
Yes,
yes, that was
yes.
Established.
Does your service have anything to do with food or drink?
No.
9 down and 1 to go, Miss Francis.
You aren't a bouncer.
No.
No, but you're getting at least close. That's 10 down and no more to go. How about a private detective?
Oh! Ah.
Miss Dougherty is with the Ross Bureau of Investigation in Philadelphia, and a license, their license. Miss Dougherty works for them as a corporation, does most of her work actually as a store detective. So that I felt there was a possibility one member of the panel might come into contact with Miss Dougherty.
I thought I saw her the other day rushing in and out of a store. Most unobtrusively.
But for no specific purpose.
No specific
no
purpose.
No specific purpose. Miss Dougherty, thank you very much. Nice to have you with us in What's My Life. All right, now to meet our second challenger. Will you enter and sign in, please? Herb Jenks, right, sir?
Right.
And where are you from, Mr. Jenks?
Costa Mesa, California.
And Costa Mesa is near?
South of Los Angeles.
South of Los Angeles, right. Down around San Diego, in that
Newport.
Area? Down Newport area?
Right.
Got some friends in San Diego here. I thought maybe you might be neighbors.
Not quite.
Well, may I present our panel?
How do you do?
All right, Mr. Jenks, will you join me over here? Do you know how we keep score on What's My Line?
Yes, sir.
Good show. Then we'll let the folks at home and the folks in the theater know exactly what your line is. All right. Panel, Mr. Jenks, the salary deals in a product, and we'll begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Is it a product one would buy in a store?
Yes.
Would you ever buy it as a gift for someone?
Yes.
You would, but I think with Mr. Jenks' permission, it would be an unusual gift, and the circumstances of its purchase as a gift would perhaps be less numerous than you would anticipate.
Would it be, if one had one, wouldn't you keep it in a special room of the house?
I presume so.
Would it be more likely to be kept in a kitchen area?
No. One down and nine to go, Mr. Cook.
Would I be able to carry it?
Oh, yes.
Is it larger than my fist?
Yes.
Is it something which, when I received it as a surprise, because it's not usually given as a gift, would it arrive in a cardboard box?
Yes.
I sound very knowing. It's no help to me at all. I've never had anything arrive in a cardboard box and I can think of it. Would I be right in assuming that you can't eat this?
Right.
You sure I wouldn't try?
Yes, we're sure you wouldn't try.
Would you be pleased to get one of these?
No.
It isn't really fair, Peter, to give you a no, but you asked the question. Mr. Jenks really would be pleased if he got one. He'd like something else. Miss Kilgallen.
Then is this a necessity rather than a luxury?
No.
No, I would say here that we would have to agree that while it is necessary to the particular function that is performed, it certainly isn't to be considered a necessity in the average American home. Mr. Cerf?
Mr. Jenks, might this object be bought in an ordinary sort of store?
What is an ordinary sort of store?
Well, a department store or a store where they sell garden machinery or tools or things of that sort.
No. Four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
If Mr. Jenks would not like to receive one of these, is it because it is something that a woman should have instead of a man?
No. Five down and five to go, Mr. Cook.
Nobody ought to have one.
No, always.
Listen, Mr. Jenks.
Mr. Jenks just is purely subjective when he says he wouldn't be particularly pleased. After all, he's got one already. Let's face it. Mr. Cook?
Do you get given several for Christmas? I mean, do you... advertise this product, not yourself, but is this product heavily advertised? Or is it assumed to be something everybody ought to have, even though it's not a necessity?
No. Six down and four to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Is this solid rather than liquid?
Rather than what?
Liquid.
Yes.
Is it something that has to be used in conjunction with something else to function properly?
Well, it has to be used, I think we can agree, in conjunction with something else to be used with any real meaning, yes. Mm-hmm.
Well, in other words, if I had one, it wouldn't be just lying around on the coffee table.
I think that is a fair statement. It would not be just lying around on the coffee table.
Well, is it, in fact, rather an ugly thing?
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Seven down and three to go, Mr. Cerf.
Mr. Jenks, is there any element of danger in this product?
In the product itself?
Or in the use of say?
Very rare.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would think Mr. Jenks is being very fair. We can't give you a no, Bennett, because I think improperly used, as with almost anything else, it could have elements of danger. But properly used, we'd say no.
Might this product be used in any kind of sport or entertainment?
Yes.
Would that be a really function of it?
Yes.
Would it be used in some sport?
Yes.
Would it be used in an outdoor sport?
Yes, sir.
Would it be used on a sport that is performed on land?
Yes.
Would it be a sport which teams play?
Yes.
Might it be either baseball or football?
No.
8 down and 2 to go, Miss Francis.
Oh, boy. I thought you had it. Is it an accessory for the sport? You must have one in order to play whatever this game is.
Well, you must have one to participate in
the
pattern
in
the
sport.
Of sports to which your team and yourself are dedicating yourself.
Uh-huh. Is it a sport in which animals also are interested?
Nice job. Well done, Mr. Cook.
Is it an American sport rather than an English one?
No, I don't think we can call it an American sport.
No,
I don't understand why you couldn't get this.
Boomerangs, tennis?
Boomerangs, no. It's a simple thing. You have them on the coffee table all the time. Poles for pole vaulting. That's a developer.
That's not a team sport.
Sure it is.
Oh, sure it is. You're on a track team when you go out and play.
He
makes a new
fiberglass.
With the developer and manufacturer of the fiberglass pole.
Is that's what's enabled these boys to break the records.
Yeah, right. Browning Siliflex.
Yeah. What are they up to now? Almost 18 feet, aren't they, Mr. Jenks?
Browning Siliflex.
Pardon?
Almost up to 18 feet, aren't they?
No, almost 17. 16.8¾ yesterday in London, so it's not only
John Pennell yesterday in London, 16.8¾ feet, and using one of the new Siliflex, or I guess Browning Siliflex poles, right?
We call it a sky pole, John.
That doesn't mean that the old athletes weren't good. They didn't have the equipment that you fellows give them now. Isn't that correct?
Well, by learning more techniques, I think it's more difficult in a glass pole. They can improve. As an example, Ron Morris held the records on the aluminum pole, and he is now using the fiberglass pole, and he is one of the boys who is over in Europe at the present time. Got second place in the AAU meet recently.
So I'm sure I've seen some advertising for this appalling Brand X pole, which breaks under you, whereas the fiberglass one carries you.
Well, it wasn't paid for.
Mr. Jenks, thank you very much. It's been a lot of fun. Hope you enjoyed your visit with us. Nice to have you. We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, here is a word from our sponsor. And now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery challenger, for which, as you all know, my friends in the panel, are blindfolded. Are the blindfolds in place, panel?
Yes, sir.
Good. Will you enter mystery challenger and sign in, please? All right, as you know, panel, in this case, a different form of questioning, one question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Are you a movie star?
Yeah.
Mr. Cerf?
Are you of the masculine persuasion?
Yeah.
Miss Francis?
Sounds dubious. Will you, are you appearing in a picture now being made in New York?
No.
1 down and 9 to go, Mr. Cook.
Are you a comedy performer primarily?
Yes.
Miss Kilgallen?
Oh, have you ever been on this panel?
No.
2 down and 8 to go, Mr. Cerf.
Have you been within the past season in a Broadway play?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
Are you at the present time in a Broadway play?
Yes.
Mr. Cook?
Are you Paul Ford?
Well, I must say, Peter, I thought we had you running. How did you do that?
Oh, I saw the play and I'd recognize that voice anywhere.
You would? Well, I must say, I guess there are very few of us from Maine to Florida and from Massachusetts to California who would have too much difficulty recognizing that voice. I am, might as well lay it on the table, Colonel, an old Bilko fan from way back.
Well, thank you.
An old Bilko fan from way back. And I must say,
but I changed my voice.
Well, I think you...
It was rather tough.
Yeah, it's tough, but
no,
you...
I thought Peter Cook would be the last one to get it.
Well,
sure,
I thought...
he wouldn't get it.
I was I was worried more about Arlene and Dorothy and Bennett than I was Peter.
Yeah.
But,
well, we were on the track, but...
Good ear, you know.
Yeah, Peter's got a good ear, and that... Because even when you're up high, you see it was there.
Yeah, never that was an E-flat, you know, a high E-flat.
Was that a high E-flat? Well, for heaven's sake.
I think we ought to say something about the play that Mr. Ford is so glorious in.
At the Playhouse Theater at Broadway, never too late.
And never
it's
too late.
An absolute delight. But then everything, I think, and
somebody's
I hope...
Somebody's seen it here.
I'm sure a lot of them have, and a lot more will. But I don't, Paul, I trust that this is not out of place, but... He has one of those rare and wonderful comedic personalities that just, I just watch him stand there and not say a word, and I start to giggle. Funny thing.
I hope that's all right.
Paul, may I thank you for, I know you're doing a regular show is hard work, and it's nice of you to give us a Sunday night, and it's a joy and an honor to have had you on What's
My
Life.
A lot of fun. Thank you.
Thanks very much. In balance, I guess we'll have to say you didn't do too badly so far tonight, panel, and we'll be back after this word from our alternate sponsor. And on that note, may I say, good night, Miss Arlene Francis.
See you during the week, John, and it's all right, Virginia. I'll see you too. Good night, Peter, and I hope the establishment is a big success in San Francisco in August when you open there.
Thank you very much. And good night, Dorothy, and I hope you have a great time in London.
Thank you very much, Peter. Good night, Bennett.
John, on behalf of your wife and myself, may I ask you to please behave yourself at that beauty contest in Florida next week.
Arlene's my chaperone. What more could anybody ask, I would say. It's going to be fun. And I think if you haven't met that wonderful young lady, Norma Beatrice Nolan, who is the current Miss Universe, you've missed something, because she really is, in every sense of the word, a fine young lady. And it's going
she
to be a journey.
Brazil last year, wasn't
Argentina.
She? Argentina.
Miss Argentina, yeah.
Didn't Miss England sprain her ankle? I read that.
Well, actually, I'm not sure.
I read that.
You mean this current, in the current term?
This current one, while she was warming up, she sprained her ankle.
Going to be a bit untidy with that cast, isn't it? Well, we hope for the best. And thanks to all of you for being with us on What's My Line.
What's My Line is a CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Todman. This is Johnny Olson speaking.
No. They charge.
Four down. No, they don't. And actually, remember, Miss Dougherty works for a profit-making organization. This has been, I think, developed and deals in a service. Mr. Cerf?
Miss Dougherty, yes. Do you require any special training for the service that you perform?
Yes.
Is it a certain kind of schooling that you need?
You mean leading to a degree or having the
Not
character?
Not necessarily having a degree, but some kind of training in some kind of course that enables you to do the work that you are now doing.
Yes.
Do you wear any kind of special uniform for the work that you do?
No.
$5 and $5 to go, Miss Francis.
I have a feeling we're getting no place.
You are.
Yes. We're getting no place. Do you ever take anybody outside that has been inside with you?
No.
You don't take them out?
Sometimes.
It's possible that in the conveyance of the service, Miss Dougherty might have occasion to take somebody outside who was inside.
Yes.
Would you ever work with people that were not quite well? None of us are, really.
Well, not specifically, and the fact of their health or lack
of
it would not
be
germane. No, that's $6 and $4. I'm going to give you one more minute because you're wandering afield.
Do you think us asking you the whole time whether you go in or out is any help to us at all?
No, that's absolutely right. No, that's $7 and $3 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Do you work in or near a building that has any significance other than an office building? In other words, if we knew what kind of a building you worked in or near, would we have a clue to your profession?
Not necessarily.
Not necessarily.
No. $8 and $2 to go, Mr. Cerf.
Miss Dougherty, does your service... We never did establish the fact that whether or not you worked for a profit-making organization.
Yes,
yes, that was established.
Does your service have anything to do with food or drink?
No.
$9 and $1 to go, Miss Francis.
You aren't a bouncer.
No.
No, but you're getting at least close. That's $10 and no more to go. How about a private detective?
Oh! Aha.
Miss Dougherty is with the Ross Bureau of Investigation in Philadelphia.
My time. I was thinking of going to the diplomatic service before I did this. Would I find you inside?
Yes.
When you had rendered this service, would I have benefited in an intellectual capacity? Would I have learned something about something from you?
Well, I would say here this would much depend on your relationship to Miss Dougherty at the time that the service was conveyed. Under one circumstance, we would agree that you might learn something, right?
Yes.
Under another, we might agree that you still had learned something, but might not necessarily seek the information.
I see. I might as well be about as puzzled as I am now, in fact. in your outside capacity, do you work at all with animals?
No.
No. $3 and $7 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Could I use your services, too?
Yes.
Do you work with your hands?
You mean specifically to the exclusion of,
Oh, I don't want to exclude anything.
But to the exclusion of the normal experience of, do you work, I mean, we wouldn't say you worked with your hands as a specific fact, but you do use your hands in your work. How
yes,
do you mean?
I type.
Yeah. Well, now, do you mean, does Miss Dougherty ever use her hands, or does she principally use her hands?
Ever.
Ever. Well, I guess you're in pretty safe ground now.
Do you, when you move from indoors to outdoors, move for a reason rather than just the fact that you like it outdoors more than indoors?
Yes.
Is it because there are people out there who want your service?
No.
Well, here again, with your permission, Miss Dougherty, I would say that people are involved, that if Miss Dougherty went outside, it would probably have something to do with people. It would be something with, having to do with people would take her from one place to another. That's fair, isn't it?
Yes.
Do people pay you directly rather than charging it?
To you by Geritol, the high-potency vitamin iron-rich tonic in liquid or tablets to help you feel stronger. And now, let's all play What's My Line? And now, live from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now, a very delightful gentleman indeed, who, with his three glorious confreres, has just completed the 300th performance of the comedy hit Beyond the Fringe, Mr. Peter Cook.
It's my pleasure to introduce the celebrated crime reporter, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
My pleasure to introduce the president of Random House, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
And here's our distinguished panel moderator, a man with a superb physique. In fact, he has one of the largest vocabularies extant, Mr. John Charles Daly.
Peter Cook, it's nice to see you on the panel. Matter of fact, I think we're going to give you a good half hour. We have some fun here for you. Arlene and I are going to be a little proud and peacock tonight. We're going to be Miss Universe next Saturday, and just think of the rest of you folks. Their license, Miss Dougherty works for them as a corporation, does most of her work actually as a store detective. So that I felt there was a possibility one member of the panel might come into contact with Miss Dougherty.
I thought I saw her the other day rushing in and out of a store. Most unobtrusively.
But for no specific purpose.
No specific purpose.
Miss Dougherty, thank you very much. Nice to have you with us in What's My Life. All right, now to meet our second challenger. Will you enter and sign in, please? Herb Jenks, right, sir?
Right.
And where are you from, Mr. Jenks?
Costa Mesa, California.
And Costa Mesa is near?
South of Los Angeles.
South of Los Angeles, right. Down around San Diego, down
Newport
area. Down Newport area?
Right.
Got some friends in San Diego here. I thought maybe you might be neighbors.
Not quite.
Well, may I present our panel?
How do you do?
All right, Mr. Jenks, will you join me over here? Do you know how we keep score on What's My Line?
Yes, sir.
Good show. Then we'll let the folks at home and the folks in the theater know exactly what your line is. Jenks, the salary deals in a product, and we'll begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Is it a product one would buy in a store?
Yes.
Would you ever buy it as a gift for someone?
Yes.
You would, but I think with Mr. Jenks' permission, it would be an unusual gift, and the circumstances of its purchase as a gift would perhaps be less numerous than you would anticipate.
Would it be, if one had one, wouldn't you keep it in a special room of the house?
I presume so.
Would it be more likely to be kept in a kitchen area?
No. One down and nine to go, Mr. Cook.
Would I be able to carry it?
Oh, yes.
Is it larger than my fist?
Yes.
Is it
going to be Mrs. Universe?
You're going to be Mrs. Universe or Miss Universe, I don't know which, on Saturday. But we do have some fun, I think, tonight in hand for you, and we'll also have a famous mystery guest before our panel a little bit later in the program. We'll meet our first challenger after this one. And now to meet our first contestant, will you enter and sign in, please? Carolyn Dougherty, is that right? Is it
Miss or Mrs.?
Miss.
Miss Dougherty. And where are you from, ma'am?
Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Philadelphia? City of brotherly love. It's nice to have you with us. Miss Dougherty, may I present our panel? Now, will you join me over here? Do you know how we keep score on What's My Line?
Yes, I do.
All right, fine. Then we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Miss Dougherty is salaried and deals in a service, and we'll begin the general questioning with Bennett Cerf.
Miss Dougherty, am I correct in surmising that there's a bit of Irish in you somewhere or other?
Yes.
It's inconceivable to me that a girl as lovely as you wouldn't have something to do with the field of entertainment. Have you?
No.
No? What
one down, nine to go, Miss Fred.
Do you work for a profit-making organization?
Yes, I do.
Do you work indoors?
Sometimes.
You move around in your work?
Yes.
You personally move around?
Yes.
Is there anything athletic at all in what you do?
No.
Nope. Two down and eight to go, Mr. Cook.
Miss Dougherty, if I was to come to you for your service, would I be more likely to catch you inside or outside? Or, would I follow you around as you move from one part to the other?
Well, now, that's two questions, Peter.
I realize there's no answer to it. I'm just biting my...